Hello everyone and welcome back to The Teacher. In this tutorial, you will learn how to combine 2D shapes and 3D models to create some stunning animations in Microsoft PowerPoint. So, let's get started and you can freely download this presentation from our website and the link is given in the video description and in the cards. The animation is inspired by the work of Ben Evans at CodePen.io. I just added a few more elements to make it look like a 3D animation in PowerPoint. This tutorial also reminded me of one of my previous tutorials about creating 3D movement from still photos in which I had created a fake 3D animation using 2D shapes. You can also watch this video for more information, and the link is given in the description and in the cards. After downloading and opening the presentation, it's always a good idea to open the selection pane to investigate all the objects on the slide. Here we can see 8 objects in total. 5 of them are 2D shapes, and the rest are 3D models. The 3D airplane is a pre-animated model. I just placed that on the place on the slide, and you can see it is automatically animating in a loop. The walls, floor, roof, and the window have been drawn using the freeform shape tools. So if you hide all the layers of the slide by clicking the Hide All button from the selection pane, and then start turning on each layer by clicking the Eye button, then you can notice how both 2D and 3D shapes have been placed together. Now, let's open the animation pane from the Animations tab to see all the animation effects applied to the objects on the slide. For the 3D pre-animated airplane, I am using scene 4 with a duration of 5 seconds and repeating the animation 6 times, which makes the total duration of the animation 30 seconds. Then I applied the grow shrink effect with a size of 350% with auto reverse and a time duration of 15 seconds. As the auto reverse has been applied, the duration of the effect will be 30 seconds. This will create an illusion as the airplane size is increasing as the camera moves inside the room. You can notice that on the rest of the layers the same grow shrink animation effect has been applied. You can double click on an effect to open the effect options from where you can note down the growth or shrink size, horizontal, vertical or both directions, smoothness and auto reverse. The turntable effect has been applied to the 3D fan. Then you can see 5 motion path effects have been applied. To the right wall, right motion path. For the left wall, left motion path. For the floor, down motion path. For the floor and table, down motion path. And for the fan, up motion path. I didn't apply any motion path to the front wall, as I need to grow it horizontally alone. So, if I delete all the motion path effects and see the slideshow, then you can see what is going on the screen. Now it has created a squeezing effect as the walls are going to collapse. But with grow, shrink and motion path animations, it creates an illusion as the camera is moving towards the front wall, and the object in the room seems to be getting larger. When the auto reverse begins after 15 seconds, then motion paths get reversed and sizes start getting normal, and then it creates an illusion as the camera is moving outside from the room. I hope you will like this technique that can help you to create some more creative animations in PowerPoint. Thanks a lot for reading. Don't forget to like, share, and comment. Bye and take care.